last remaining items from the studio.
But it is too hot. I'm gonna go get some lunch at Garage Coffee.
So this place is Marathon Motor Works, and it used to be a automobile factory in the early 1900s. Barry Walker bought it in the late 80s, early 90s, totally derelict, run down, and he's really turned the place into a destination. It's a tourist hub. All these buildings are filled with studios, creative people like us, photographers, designers, videographers, people who make stuff, and then lots of cool shops. As he's been cleaning up and renovating, he's been finding old photographs and advertisements and cool stuff from the early 1900s that have to do with the cars. It's been a great place to have a studio. Love it. Yeah, so all weekend long there are tourists coming down here. You can always tell it's like one person convinced a whole group to come down to the American Pickers store, which is right over there. And then it takes them maybe 8 minutes to go through the store. Can't really buy much except hats and t-shirts. And then they start wandering around the property like lost sheep. So when we moved down here, we got a studio so that we could shoot videos for an online course. And we soon discovered after we moved into the studio that we were right next to the train tracks. Which made it super difficult to record video and sound. I mean, really difficult.
Dirty chai, a cup of water, a Palermo, and a bag of chips.
Sorry, this guy is working on that tractor, trying to make it run, I guess. A lot of stuff going on today, music, tourists, people looking at old antique stuff, like these people. American Pickers has their store here, but it didn't always used to be like that. When Barry bought the building, it was scary. People did not go down here, the police did not go down here. Tons of drug addicts, prostitution, nasty stuff going on. Barry told me some crazy stories. Barry found this rattlesnake, and he was living up in one of these buildings, and he was just like, had built out the top floor as his personal hideout and penthouse or something. But all back around here, it was all overgrown weeds and junk. See the Harleys? Yeah. So he decided to take this rattlesnake one night, and he came out and there was a big party going on back here. People standing around, burning barrels, doing all sorts of nasty stuff. He had fixed like a steel rod with a noose, and he put the snake head in that noose. And he came running around out of the weeds in the middle of the night to this burn barrel. All these drug addicts and prostitutes said, "Hey man, check this out, I found a live rattlesnake. I killed about four or five up here in these weeds." He said it was like Scooby-Doo. And they did not come back. Clever man. I'm kind of waiting to get permission from our landlord and some of the people we share the space with. But I'm trying to get permission to bring over this guy tomorrow. We'll see how it goes.